Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter respiration. In that we are studying topic glycolysis. When I say glycolysis, lysis means breakdown, and when I say glyco, it means the breakdown of glucose. Today we'll see how does it happen in plants. Glycolysis. This is a term that may be new to you. Let's break down this term. Lysis, in the last part of this word, glycolysis means breakdown. And when I say glyco, it means breakdown of a substance. And this substance is nothing but glucose, the most famous carbohydrate that is produced in plants. Remember, during the process of photosynthesis that takes place in daylight, the stomata, the small openings present on the leaf, when they are open and carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, you get a substance which is called as glucose, C6H12O6, the plant food, and you get a byproduct which was oxygen and water. So the whole process of photosynthesis was basically being to perform glucose as an energy source, the food source, whether it was cyclic photophosphorylation, non-cyclic photophosphorylation, Kelvin cycle, all of them, their main aim was to produce glucose. We all know that just by eating glucose, even in human beings, you cannot gain energy. That energy could only be gained if you break down glucose. And you all know that glucose has to be broken down into an energy-giving molecule. And what is this energy-giving molecule? This is nothing but ATP, adenosine triphosphate. So the process of glycolysis, if I can place in simple manner, is nothing but the conversion of glucose, that is the plant food, into ATP under the presence of certain conditions. And these certain conditions are nothing but, it could be an aerobic condition, that is in the presence of oxygen, or it could be an anaerobic condition, that is in the absence of oxygen. The energy would be formed in both of these steps. Now, do you think that this process is going to be easy? Not really. Just to convert that glucose molecule into ATP, there are different cycles that take place in the process of respiration. And one of them is glycolysis cycle. Now, the glycolysis cycle starts with glucose, that's one molecule of glucose, and ends with molecules of pyruvate or pyruvic acid, and it produces two molecules of pyruvate or pyruvic acid. It is a large step reaction with lot of intermediates and lot of cycles or lot of reaction materials. Glycolysis will just take place once your photosynthesis is done. If there is no glucose present in the system, obviously what is the point of doing glycolysis? So once photosynthesis is done, then glycolysis comes to picture in plant cell. This process of glycolysis, that is forming of C6H12O6 into ATP in aerobic or anaerobic conditions inside a cell, is termed as respiration in plants. glycolysis. When I say glycolysis, lysis means breakdown and glyco means the breakdown of glucose, or you can say the breakdown of C6H12O6, the food source of plant, which is formed during the process of photosynthesis or the process that prepares food material for plant. It is a process of converting glucose to ATP, high energy molecule, inside plant cell. So glycolysis is nothing but the conversion of glucose into ATP. We all know that the energy currency of cell is ATP. How much quantity or whatever is the quantity of glucose a plant is preparing, it can never break down that amount of glucose and use it as an energy directly. It has to be converted into ATP, and that ATP is broken down further into ADP, that is adenosine diphosphate, further into AMP, which is adenosine monophosphate. The energy giving molecule here is the phosphate group, which is a high energy molecule. Now, glycolysis is a common step for both aerobic as well as anaerobic respiration. When I say aerobic, it means in the presence of oxygen. When I say anaerobic, it means in the absence of oxygen. In plants, respiration process begins with the breakdown of the most common carbohydrate. And when I say it begins with the breakdown of most common carbohydrate, the carbohydrate is nothing but glucose molecule. We all know that glucose, fructose, sucrose are all carbohydrates. So glucose is the carbohydrate that undergoes glycolysis process. Does glycolysis happens in human beings also? You need to find out and think about it. The process of glycolysis occurs in the cytoplasm, or you can say the jelly-like substance which is present inside the cell, in which all the cell organelles are embedded or kept, and it is an anaerobic process. When I say anaerobic process, it is not dependent on oxygen. Even if oxygen is present or oxygen is absent, glycolysis won't be hampered or stopped. Obviously, you're making an energy-giving molecule. If glycolysis was dependent on aerobic or it was dependent on oxygen, think, in the absence of oxygen, if it is not present in the system, the plant would die, because if there is no ATP available, obviously there is no energy available for the plant to sustain, and the plant will eventually die. That's the reason it is an anaerobic process. In human beings, do you think it could be an anaerobic process? We can have an anaerobic process inside our body? No, we can never have an anaerobic process inside our body. Every process is aerobic in human beings, since we continuously inhale oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. Students, glycolysis is not a simple process. It is an 11-step reaction. And in that 11 step, intermediate places will form ATP, which will form as an energy source. Various molecules are used, various combinations, enzymes like isomerase, pyruvate, kinase, all of them come into picture. And finally, you get ATP molecules. Respiration doesn't stop on glycolysis. It further goes to Krebs cycle and TC as well. Students, I hope you all are clear with this concept of what glycolysis actually means and where does it take place. Thank you.